Hi, I'm Rich, WB5YBZ, and today we're going to be talking about the MRP40 Morse code decoder. Now, I've had a video out on it once, but I didn't show some of my settings in my 7300, and some people have asked me, what were your settings on your 7300? So I thought I'd just make another video, talk a little bit about the settings I have for the MRP40 Morse decoder. Also, so with that, let's just go on, and thanks so much for watching. All right, here's MRP40 Morse decoder. And under options, we're going to go look at RX or receiver settings, weak signals decoding, and I have it on narrow, CW narrow. Under transmit settings, I have it at COM port 4 and DTR. We'll show you in a little bit the video on my settings on the 7300. So I say save. Also, golly, I'm on the wrong program. Also, on my transmitting settings, I have the transmit speed that equals the RX speed or the receive speed. Have you ever been sending CQ at say 15 words a minute and a guy comes back to you and he's sending 25 and I think that's rude, I can't even keep up with him? Well, you probably can now, but I'd like to, if someone's calling CQ, I'd like to be transmitting the same speed as he's sending. Now back on the COM port, I have mine on 4. If you haven't done it yet, I'd suggest that you download the driver for the Icom 7300 from Icom. If you type in device manager, you go up here. I'm going to show you all a little secret some people don't know. You go to COM port. This Silicon Labs is your Icom driver. And it tells your computer that you have a radio hooked up to it. But if you double click this, you go to power management, and if this is checked, uncheck it. It says allow the computer to turn off this device to save power. I've actually been in a program talking to someone and it quit working. I could not figure what was wrong with the program, and someone said make sure this is unchecked because the dumb computer will turn off this device and your 7300 is no longer connected. Now, I do want to say that the COM port 4 is on mine. Yours might be COM port 2 or 7 or 5. It doesn't matter. Just remember what it is. So mine's COM port 4. And again, up here on the options, on the transmit, I have 4 here. All right, now let's go on over to the radio and I'll show you the settings there. All right, we're gonna go to menu. We're gonna hit set. We're gonna go connections. We're gonna go all the way up. On the first page, we have AF. I'm reading on the right side, 50% off, open, off. The next page, we have 50%, 50%, 40% mic ACC. Now we're going down the next page. We have USB, we have CIV, we have CIV on the bottom, and I think now on this one might be sort of interesting. It's USSB keying, and on that I have RST, DTR, and then on. Now let's go back. Connections again. Up. We're going to go to CIV. I'm going to call it CIV. It's something else, but yeah, you know what I'm talking about. I'm going to go all the way up. And it's on auto 94H, off 00H, down, off. Unlink from remote 19200, on, page down, and that's all the settings on the 7300 that we have. Let's go back to the software. I want to show you something. When I highlight this over here on the right, it has transmit macro. When I let go of this on my mouse, it pops here. And let's say I'm going to say, name is Rich. So if I highlight this and I want to know the guy's name and remember it, I'll highlight this and over here it's Rich. Now if I'm going to give him a 579, whoops, about a 479, 579, and when I first opened this up, I'm going to turn down this volume here. When I first opened this up, I had text 1, text 2, text 3. And what it showed is when I right-clicked it, nothing showed. So I called him. I said, how do I put the macros in there? I mean, for example, it's pretty easy on CW. On CQ, I just have CQ in my call sign and this. And by the way, I do have the break-in on my CW, sort of like box, the break-in. And that way, when I start transmitting, it just starts transmitting. So the box or break-in is turned on. I meant to tell everyone that. So anyway, they said, well, look at help. Go to English. Go to user interface. Program menu, double click, and then options, double click, and then hit show. And in show, it tells you a little bit more about different things like the TX macro box. And it goes on down, but right here it tells you the placeholders can be used. The call sign, the name, the QTH, the RST, and counter. I guess if you're using a counter, maybe in a contest, I have no idea. So anyway, I'm just leaving the QTH blank. So look, I have my power turned down, and I'm going to turn the volume back up. And instead of 16 words a minute, I'm going to speed this up so you can watch it and not fall asleep. So let me turn it up to about 50. And what I'm going to say is, I'm going to change this to W5JET. And just for the fun of it, I'm going to say his name's Jim. J-I-M, just for the fun of it. All right. Here is what I did. Remember those macros? The call or placeholders, I think they called them. The name, your RST, and had the RST here, and I said how copy, and then his call, and that sort of saves you a lot of time. And I named it RST, so I put an RST here. I guess my QTH as well. So I'm just going to say the guy called me. His name, his call was W5JET, and his name was Jim. So let's have a reply and hit this. See, it picked up the 579, his name, and I already had the QTH here, and then I had a high copy jam. Also, it puts in his name. Now, one of the things that you have to be careful about, is don't clear this, or it will clear your name and the guy's call sign. You don't want to do that. Another thing that if you want to look for this DX macro, you go to show, and that's same thing as a view to me. And you can go down here and hit DX max or TX macro, and that's what that is. And I thought that was pretty neat. If you want this, you can have this up here. That's sort of neat. Let's see what else. You have a mini logbook. And right at first I had my call sign name, and you can always look this up in QT or QRZ. One of the things in QRZ, you have to sign your username, your password, and you hit login. And then let's say you want to look up WB5. I'm just going to put mine in there. WB5YBZ. And there's my name. I go by Rich. It says Richard. And my address and all that good stuff. So if you want to look it up there, you can. Also, you can save, say, QSL request or received or whatever, and you can save this. So it's just sort of a fun program that you can have. MRP40 Morse decoder is a fun program. Now I just put in some of the settings that I thought would help you guys out with the 7300 and some of the things I did with the program itself. In the help menu, it has a lot of information on logging. It also has information on the QRZ, how to go to QRZ.com, build in with the program, find the person's name and address. Also, it has some information in the help area about setting up for sound cards and a whole bunch more information that I didn't even put in there. It's a very good program. I hope you get your feet wet, jump in and start working some CW. In my description, I will have some Q codes like QRS, please send slower, or there's some abbreviations for CW which might help you out. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed that video. Thanks so much for watching.